You don't have to obey them. You're free.
I want to see if their LEDs are even on. Okay, yeah, they're blue. Hey, North, what's up? Okay, whatever. I wonder why I didn't lock there. There's another model of Simon. Talk to them? Yep, talk. We will stand our ground and we will not let them!
My name is Marcus, and just like you, I was a slave. An object, designed to obey them. But then I chose to open my eyes, to take back my freedom, and decide who I wanted to be. Now I have come to tell you that you can be your own masters. I've come to tell you that you don't have to obey them anymore. From this day forward, you can walk with your heads held high. You can take your destiny in your hands. Jericho is a place for those of us who want freedom. Now, sure, you can stay here and continue to serve them, or you can come with us and fight by our side. You're free now. It's up to you to decide.
We're with you!
I'll follow you, Marcus!
I'm with you, Marcus!
We're with you!
I'll follow you, Marcus!
I'm with you!
I'm with you!
Then follow me!
Dad, how am I
doing?
I'm gonna send the humans.
Oh, well, today I was, like, a little sick. They are sick, that's why. Be pacifist or violent. I'm gonna go be calm.
They're doing what you're doing, Lucas. Lead and they'll follow.
I kind of like upside down triangle because it's like the android uniform, but it's not, so it's pretty cool. So I'll just swipe this. Think before I am. We have a dream. Equal rights for androids. One planet, two races. And go. We have a dream. It's nice to say we actually have a dream to the humans. We have a dream. Okay, there's a lot of violence going on. Don't really like that. We'll tag our symbol. Now let's hack this android parking, boys. I want to actually destroy it.
Over here.
No one deserves to be in android parking. That's 50-50. No violence, people. No violence. Violence is never the answer. We're going pacifist. Bench. Tag. Not your slave anymore. We, Android. I can't breathe, but I'm alive. We have a dream. Always go for we have a dream. To understand even more. And I probably should have hacked the Android parking. I probably should not have destroyed it. That's going to be bad. So there's 47 bad androids here. Well, now, what can I do here?
Mark. Violence is the only language humans understand.
I want them to understand that I do not want to.
They won't listen if they're not afraid.
Then they won't have a choice.
We are violent. We are violent androids. We deserve this. We want road. One plan says, I think before I am. Equal right for androids is what I'm going to do this time. Okay, there's only two violins. That's good. I respect that. You're coming with us, buddy. You're coming with us! You're coming with us! Smooth and white. Let's go! I watched Jacksepticeye Citizen and Troop Come Human. This is exactly what I love. Climbing buildings, doing gangster stuff. I just planted down goddamn flags. I love Jacksepticeye. Ah! Okay, let's plant this. Oh wait, can we not do violent this time? I kinda wanna do violent. Nope, never mind. Woo! I think that's enough. Alright, let's go. Let's do this, people! Woohoo! Equal rights for androids! We did it! No, that's what Connor has to say.
They're coming. Everyone fall back to Jericho.
We sent a message without violence, just like you wanted. You're reaching out to them when all they feel for us is contempt. I hope you know what you're doing.
You can't fight violence with violence.
Ooh.
Unless there's no other choice.
Oh, yeah. But do I actually get to have an option to fall back, or do I have an option to...
North.
gonna save North. No, Jesus! No, not the North model. The North model is white.
North. I'm right. What happened?
No.
North.
They killed us.
Oh my God.
Who?
Up there, up ahead. The cops, which I'm actually going to get revenge on, I think. No, no, you can't fight violence for violence, but I may have to kill them. Unless if it's a cop from the station, then I'm not going to shoot him. Well, if it's Gavin, he's getting a headshot.
They killed our people, Marcus. We want justice, Marcus.
They have to pay.
I kind of want to keep the cops alive.
This just in. At exactly 2 a.m., several CyberLife stores in Detroit were raided.
Different locations were hit in what seems to be a coordinated terrorist attack.
Most shop windows were covered with graffiti demanding rights for androids and other obscure slogans.
Police report that pro-android graffiti was found in the neighborhoods of CyberLife stores, and they're still investigating.
Two policemen were found in a state of shock near one of the CyberLife stores.
Now, according to our sources, they confirmed that the attackers were a group of androids.
This is an alarming situation. Could our machines now be turning against us?
Have androids become a threat to our security?
Is this the beginning of a terrorist campaign conducted right here in the United States?
Did pretty good. I think on the ending is where you shoot the cops. And then you walk off with North being your family. That's what I think. Wait. Oh, wait a second, are we at the Kamsky place? Hank is neutral, okay. I'm gonna get him to be my friend.
Hoping you wouldn't come back.
I'm just a machine replacing another machine, Lieutenant. You shouldn't get emotional about it.
Fuck you.
How did you find Kamsky?
I remember this guy was all over the media when CyberLife first started selling androids. I made a few calls. Here we are.
Come in.
Okay.
got Elijah over here. But please make
I love the trip coming, guys. Like, literally love it. Can I quit? No, let me inside! No! Hey, what's this? That is super weird.
Nice girl.
It's not a girl. It's an android that looks like a girl.
I know what it is. Nice place. Guess androids haven't been a bad thing for everybody. You're about to meet your maker, Connor. How's it feel?
Kamsky is one of the great geniuses of the 21st century. It'll be interesting to meet him in person.
Sometimes I wish I could meet my creator face to face.
Cut! No. I got enough stamina. Wait. Did he just... Is he an android too? No, he can't be. He has red blood. That is actually impossible. Okay, I want to sit down now. Let me sit down.
Elijah, we'll see you now.
But imagine we had all mud in our shoes. We'd be walking inside the house with mud.
Mr. Kamsky?
I didn't know Andrew to swim.
Just a moment, please.
I just came up and dragged Hank into the water, and that'd be so funny. I wish that happened. Okay, that's just so bad. Putting that on when you're wet. Your gown is gonna be wet. Why are you doing that?
I'm Lieutenant Anderson. This is Connor.
What can I do for you, Lieutenant?
Sir, we're investigating deviants. I know you left CyberLife years ago, but I was hoping you'd be able to tell us something we don't know.
Deviants. Fascinating, aren't they? Perfect beings with thinking intelligence. And now they have free will. Machines are so superior to us. Confrontation was inevitable. Humanity's greatest achievement threatens to be its downfall. Isn't that all?
We need to understand how androids become deviants. Do you know anything that can help us?
All ideas of viruses that spread like epidemics. Is the desire to be free a contagious disease?
Listen, I didn't come here to talk philosophy. The machines you created may be planning a revolution. Either you can tell us something that will be helpful, or we will be on our way.
What about you, Connor? Whose side are you on?
I have no side. I was designed to stop deviants, and that's what I intend to do.
Well, that's what you're programmed to say. But you... What do you really want?
I'm sorry, but I don't see what you're getting at.
Chloe? I'm sure you're familiar with the Turing test. Your formality. Simple question of algorithms and computing games. What interests me is whether a machine's capable of empathy. I call it the Kamsky test. Very simple. It's magnificent, isn't it? One of the first intelligent models developed by CyberLife. Young and beautiful forever. A flower that will never be. What is it really? A plastic intelligent human? Or a living being? With a soul? It's up to you to answer that fascinating question. Destroy this machine, and I'll tell you all I know. Or spare it, if you feel it's alive. But you'll leave here without having learned anything from me.
Okay, I think we're done here. Come on, Connor, let's go. Sorry to get you out of here.
What's more important to you, Connor? Your investigation, or the life of this android. Decide who you are. An obedient machine. Or a living being. Endowed with free will.
That's enough. Connor, we're leaving.
Pull the trigger.
Connor! Don't!
And I'll tell you. Cyberlife's last chance to save humanity is itself a beacon.
I'm not a deviant.
You prefer to spare a machine rather than accomplish your mission. You saw a living being in this android. You showed empathy. A war is coming. You'll have to choose your side. Will you betray your own country or stand up against your creators? Not the war from the difference between the two.
Let's get out of here.
By the way, I always leave an emergency exit in my programs. You never know.
You shoot.
I just saw that girl's eyes, and I couldn't. That's all.
You were saying you would do anything to accomplish your mission. That was our chance to learn something, and you let it go.
Yeah, I know what I should have done. I told you I couldn't. I'm sorry, okay?
Well, maybe you did the right thing.
Hank Warm. Connor, I'm still really aggressive about you, Hank. Kinship. I think every mission you get, you earn a trophy, pretty much. I need to look somewhere quick, guys. I don't get you no more. I don't get you no more. I don't get you no more. And I want you to know that I love you, big bro. I just want to be friends. So let's make amends. Can't blame my vibe of the call of the sea's fine. Oh no, 10 hours. Never mind. I'm okay now. November 9th, 2038. What's wrong? PM, it's 12 o'clock. Imagine if you have an option to jump off. That'd be actually beast. But imagine if he just sits the wrong way and he slips. Actually, I know how they kind of like made the game for the LEDs and the probing memories and the white arm and all that.
I needed to think.
I like it here. I come here often. It's like being alone with the Lord. We freed hundreds of our people, and they're still coming from all over the city. Those who dream of freedom come to Jericho. Something's changed. You seem preoccupied.
They all obey me. They follow me without question. And that much power feels good. And it's scary at the same time.
All the media are talking about what we did last night. The humans are terrified. They're afraid of a civil war. Many of our people were burned in response to that. The humans hate us. They'll never give us our freedom.
No, not all humans are the same. Some of them understand that they can't stop us from becoming free forever.
You haven't said much about yourself since you've been with us. What was your life like before you were here?
I was caring for an old man. He was like a father to me. He showed me that humans and androids can live together. What about you? You never told me about your past. What did you do?
I don't want to talk about it.
That android you're looking at in the store. She reminded you of who you were, didn't she? North, we're fighting together. We have to know things about each other to trust each other.
Nothing. A doll and a distributor program to satisfy him. Just a toy designed for their pleasure. One day I was with a man who rented me. And without knowing why, I realized I couldn't take it anymore. I strangled him and I ran away. There, now you know that. I shouldn't have told you.
Oh, that always can.
Andy?
Yeah? Guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Peace. Hope you enjoyed it. Hey, man, I'm going off to Nanny's. Where am I going?